In this tutorial, we'll explore these new features in reports for the February-March 2021 release. Excluding zero data values in charts, dynamically applying value or percent offsets to the minimum and maximum data values in charts, auto-completing manual entry of functions and members in the formula bar, aligning prefixes, suffixes, and data in reports, suppressing missing reports in a book, and bursting reports to Excel. In previous product releases, charts always plotted zero values. This was most noticeable in line charts. In this example, the chart plots a zero value for Q4. This release adds a new chart general property, which allows you to choose if charts plot zero values. The default is true. I'll change the property to false and preview the report. Notice that the chart line no longer plots the zero value for Q4. With previous releases, when you edited the axes for a chart, you had the option to specify a fixed custom minimum and maximum range for the y-axis. This might not be effective if the range of data values changed based on POV changes. You can now specify a custom range to dynamically apply either a value or a percent offset to the minimum and maximum plotted data values. You can apply these custom range settings to all chart types except for pie, donut, radar, and polar. When you select one of these custom range settings, you do not manually enter a value for step. The system calculates this value automatically. I'll reset the range to off and preview the chart. In this example, with the custom range set to off, the chart automatically calculates the minimum and maximum range of the y-axis based on the data values. In this example, I have set the range to offset by value, with minimum and maximum values. Let's preview the chart. The y-axis maximum and minimum values are offset by the values set in the custom range. In this example, I have set the range to offset by percentage, with minimum and maximum values. Let's preview the chart. The y-axis maximum and minimum values are offset by the percent values set in the custom range. You can now manually enter members and functions in the grid formula bar, and autocomplete will list matches based on your entry. For functions that have inclusive as a parameter, for example, children or descendants, you can now toggle inclusive from the formula bar. You can also copy a selection and paste it into the formula bar of another header cell for the same dimension. Autocomplete supports most functions, except those requiring multiple parameters: except, intersect, match, period offset, property, and range. In this report, symbols such as currency and percentage and data values are not aligned. You can now align prefix and suffix symbols in cell number formatting using two new properties, align prefix and align suffix. Let's preview the grid. Prefixes, suffixes, and data are now aligned. Previously, if a report had suppression enabled and a POV selection had missing data, the report results with missing data would still be included in the book output as a blank page. Now, for any reports with suppressed grids, missing data is not included in the book output. For example, this report has missing data for no segment. If I generate a book for this report, you can see that the book does not include the missing data for no segment. No special setting is required. The report must have suppression enabled for the entire grid, with no other objects, such as text boxes or images, in the body of the report. You can have text boxes or images in the header of the report. Bursting now provides the ability to burst report output to Excel as well as PDF. Similar to PDF, you can email Excel output or publish it to the library. Note, currently this feature is available for reports only. Book output is still PDF only. Let's execute the bursting definition. The Excel bursting reports are visible in the library. Open a report to view it in Excel. To learn more, visit docs.oracle.com.